Now then, a third of those surveyed for the hygiene behavioural study commissioned by Dettol admitted that they don't always wash their hands with soap and after using the toilet. Furthermore, almost half of those questioned don't always wash their hands before eating or preparing food. Now, tell us a little bit, John, about the hidden dangers around the house and what sort of germs are lurking in our households.
Well, unexpectedly, I think, quite a lot of germs are lurking in the household, and they don't normally lurk in the bathroom or the toilet because everyone cleans those.
Oh, okay.
The end of the world. They tend to lurk in the kitchen. Right. And they tend to be from, say, chickens. They tend to be from lettuces and cabbages from the garden because manure is used.
Right.
And they tend to be from children.
Right.
So there's quite a lot of feces and bacteria associated with that in the kitchen area.
Yuck. So how do we go about keeping our homes safe and germ-free for our families?
Well, fortunately, I mean, with these modern disinfectants, I mean, Dettol is one example, they've been formulated using advanced chemistry, and they can kill bacteria and kill viruses. So what you have to do is work out where they are, these bacteria and viruses, in the kitchen sink, on the door handles, you know, on the children's toys, on the pushchair, and just give it a spray and then wipe it off. So you can, once you've identified that it is a problem, you can then get rid of them pretty fast.
Okay, so contact surfaces then, really, places where kids put their fingers, where we put the fingers, then put them
yes.
in their mouth. Remote controls, light switches, that
yes,
sort of thing.
Exactly so. And then you can have a go at your hands at the same time and wash your hands properly as well. Those two things, quite simple really, but you can have an immense impact on these bacteria.
Okay, so talking about personal hygiene then, the study found that we weren't actually very good at it. What should we be doing?
Well, we should be doing more of those simple things. And the study that we've just commissioned recently is a wonderful study, the biggest study that's ever been done on social habits and hygiene and health. This is the Dettol Habit Study. And that's come up with some terribly interesting stuff. I mean, for example, it shows that people's manners correlate very strongly with their ability to use hygiene to their best advantage.
Okay.
And then they themselves get fewer infections. Now, how about that?
Mm.
So, and it also tells us that if you can form a habit, if you can get hygiene as a habit, do it routinely, like putting a safety belt on in the car, you're into it, you're away.
So and teach the kids young, get them young.
Teach the children young, and from then on, you can, keeping your fingers crossed, we will turn into a better, more safe, and more certainly more hygienic society, and that will please me.
Okay, lovely. Well, it's not a brain surgery, is it? It's only hand washing. So if we all did it a little bit more, then our households would be a lot safer.
Yeah.
Okay, John, well, thanks very much for coming in. If you'd like to get involved in the conversation on Twitter, it's at Hygiene Council, or you can go to the website, which is hygienecouncil.com. So get hand washing. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.